Hello everyone, Alex here from WarrenOffKeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can use different polling features using Discord.js to get feedback from your community. So if we go into the WarrenOffKeys Discord, and if we look at the new content channel, whenever a bot automatically posts whenever a new video is uploaded, it will automatically add a thumbs up and thumbs down reaction so people can just click thumbs up or thumbs down without having to go in and add the reactions. This is more useful if we look at suggestions. Whenever someone would type a message, like let's say test, the bot would then automatically add in the thumbs up and thumbs down reaction. It sometimes takes a few seconds. However, as you can see here, the WarrenOffKeys bot has added thumbs up and thumbs down. So this is a good way for the community to automatically have a way to just one click give feedback. And so we're going to be creating this feature right here. Another feature we're going to be creating is, let's say we type in a message here. Now we can do exclamation point poll. And if I were to send this, it would then add the thumbs up and thumbs down reaction to the test message. And this way you can allow certain roles to use this, or you can allow anyone to use this command. And it's a good way for the community to be able to get feedback. This is going to be a little bit less useful and a little bit less used. However, I'm going to show you how to use this feature as well within this video. So to get started, inside of our main file, I have this very basic project right here. You can go ahead and clone the repository, which has all the other files. However, we're not going to be using any of these files, so you can just write this out if you want to, but there will be a link to the GitHub repository if you do want to clone it in the video description. So to get started, I'm going to make a new file. So right click, new file. I'm going to make poll.js, module.exports, and we're going to have a basic callback here, which will take in a client. I am then going to import this. So const poll equals require poll. I could then invoke poll passing in the client. If I save this, we could then close our index file because everything should be working. All of our functionality and logic will now be inside of this other file. And so here we're going to create an array. We're going to call this channel IDs, and this is going to be a string array. This is the system I use, and I would pass in the new content ID as well as the suggestions ID. However, I'm going to use this private testing channel. So I'm going to right click and click on copy ID. If you don't see this, then you might have to enable the developer mode within your Discord account. So we can click on this, we can add it right here. I'm going to add a comment here. This will say testing. That way, when I add more channels, I have a better idea of which channel is what. Now we're going to create a function called add reactions, and this will take in a message. We can then say message.react, and we need to go get some emojis. So if we go over to emojipedia.org, which is where I get all my emojis from, we can go to the thumbs up emoji and we can copy this. We can paste it in right here. We could then set a timeout. Now this is technically optional. However, I prefer to have these be added in a specific order. Whenever we're using Discord.js, sometimes there's a delay or sometimes it gets the order incorrect. And so you'll see the thumbs down and then thumbs up. And I don't like the way that looks. So I prefer to have thumbs up and then a slight delay, which is 3/4 of a second here, and then a thumbs down afterwards. So we can say message.react. And if we go back to the website, we go back, we can go to thumbs down, we can copy this and we can paste it in right here. Now we want to say client.onMessage. We're going to get a callback. So this is whenever a message is sent. We can say if channel IDs.includes, and then this is going to see if this array contains a value. So we can say message.channel.id. And if this is the case, we can then add reactions passing in the message. So if we save this and we run our bot with node index.js, we see the client is ready. Going back, if I say testing, it then automatically adds a thumbs up and thumbs down reaction. So that's from the tutorial bot, which is the bot we're working with right now. Now I can go ahead and delete this. So now I'm going to add an else statement, and this is technically creating a command, and we can use this basic command handler we have. However, it's not really necessary. This is a very basic command, and I'm just going to add the logic within the poll file right here. So else if message.content.toLowercase is exactly equal to exclamation point poll. Now we want to delete this. However, we want to use await message.delete. And because we're using await, the function that this is has to be async. This is just part of JavaScript. Now what we want to do is we want to actually fetch the message that is inside the channel. So we can say constant fetched equals await message.channel.messages.fetch. And this is going to be a function. And there's a couple different things we can pass in here. But we want to pass in limit one because we're only interested in the last message that was sent. So now that we have that, we can say if fetched and fetched.first, we're then going to say add reactions, fetched.first. So this is a function that will just get the first item inside the collection, and we're just making sure that fetched is valid and also fetched.first exists. And then we're passing in the first message that we found, which is the only message we found due to limit equals one. We're then going to pass it into the add reactions. So this up here is commented out, and this is important because if this was uncommented, then this add reaction here would always be ran, and we don't want that because at the moment we want to be able to run exclamation point test, and that'd be the only way to add thumbs up and thumbs down reactions. If we had that line uncommented on line 3, then every message we sent to the channel would have those, and that negates the purpose of the pull command. So this is typically going to be used whenever people are talking in other chats that are not used within the channel IDs. So we can save this and we can run it with node index.js. Going back, we can say testing, and we should see no actual reactions being added automatically as expected. We can then say exclamation point pull, and it automatically removes that message and then adds thumbs up and thumbs down. So again, you can give any specific role access to this. That's up to your own implementation. And that is how we're going to add different polling features into your Discord server using Discord.js. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.